Hello, and thank you for watching this Northeast Regional Forecast. I'm Andrew Pritchard, meteorologist with Nutrien Ag Solutions. Well, we've seen some big change across the central and eastern United States, one that we've talked about a lot over the last week or so, and that is the arrival of yet another Arctic air mass across the region, and some snow has come with that in a swath starting from the northern plains through parts of the Midwest yesterday, and now up through the Northeast region as we get through the early part of today. Taking a look at the 24-hour temperature change, again, the core of the temperature change right now across the south into the Midwest, where you see the purple shading here, that's where we're talking about temperatures 30 to 40 degrees cooler than they were 24 hours ago. And that change is on its way through the Northeast region today as well. Now, as we talk about where we're headed, now we've talked about this big cool down for what feels like a week or two, and we're finally there, we're in it now. So where are we headed? The good news is, in one way, the good news is we're in it right now. We're dealing with the core of the coldest air right now over the next several days as we head through the 6 to 10 day time frame, starting to loosen the grip slowly. But we absolutely do not flip suddenly to a dramatically warmer pattern. It's a slow warm up, but we are bottoming out right now as we head through the next couple of days. As we talk about precipitation over the next 5 days or so, Wednesday and Thursday, we're going to watch a quick moving system bring some light snow from the northern plains through the Great Lakes, and then again possibly delivering some light snow to interior regions of the Northeast. We're also going to watch a slow moving area of low pressure across the Gulf of Mexico bring some precipitation to the southeast in the form of some rain. So two corridors here, some light snow on Wednesday and then some late week light rain. As we talk about the Northeast region as the southern portion of the Northeast region, then parts of Pennsylvania eastward toward the Atlantic, maybe dealing with some rain on the north end of this system here, but really being largely left out over the next 10 days or so as we flip to what is primarily a drier pattern. Now, that's good news. The last 7 days really reflect that pattern as well, though, seeing quick-moving systems bring some light snow from the northern plains to the Great Lakes to the interior of the Northeast region, and then Gulf moisture trying to make its way northward out of the Gulf of Mexico, but really being headed off by these Arctic intrusions, these cold, dry air masses. So seeing the corridor of the heaviest rain kind of making its way through this area. So really that's been the pattern over the last week or so. As we look at the satellite picture this morning, here is the frontal boundary right now making its way through the region, bringing some rain to southern and eastern portions of the Northeast region, some light snow falling in the interior portions of the Northeast as well. On the backside, high pressure keeping things clear across the Midwest now as they deal with the coolest temperatures of the cold air outbreak. Clockwise flow around that area of low pressure, we've got some light, some lake effect snow, I should say, over the Great Lakes as we take a look at the radar picture. Again, quieting down across the Midwest, but that clockwise flow here bringing some lake effect snow to parts of the Great Lakes, parts of the Northeast region, and a particularly intense band across northern Indiana and southwestern Michigan today, about 5 to 6 miles wide, producing some very heavy snow. As we look at the Northeast region, again, from the southeast all the way into the Northeast, seeing some rain falling in this corridor here. It's just on the north side here where we do have some snow falling. We can take a closer look at what that looks like here across parts of New York and Massachusetts. Again, some snow falling across eastern New York, along and west of that line from about Albany down to Allentown. And then as you look off to the east of that, dealing with rain here primarily across across Long Island into through Massachusetts, through Connecticut, and then into coastal portions of Maine is the word that I'm looking for. I apologize there. So looking at a mixed bag of precipitation across the Northeast region with snow to the west, a transition there where some freezing rain, a rain-snow mix is possible across this corridor in the Albany area, probably dealing with the mix. And then as you head off toward the east, dealing with rain. Temperatures, very cold. Again, this is the region we've seen temperatures drop 30 to 50 degrees over the last 24 hours, seeing temperatures below zero across parts of the Midwest where we have that fresh snowpack. And this air mass is continuing to spread off to the south and to the east, eventually overtaking the entire eastern two-thirds of the country. Now, again, the good news is we're in the worst of it now. Where are we headed? I told you it's a slow transition. The pattern right now has featured that big ridge in the Gulf of Alaska, the major trough right here, allowing a bunch of cold air into the eastern two-thirds of the country, and then the yin to that yang flipping a lot of warm air northward across the west coast into western Canada. So where do we go from here then? It is a slow transition. This ridge, or I should say this trough that's brought all the cold air, slowly begins to move off to the east. We get this next little wave that comes through on the backside. This delivers some Wednesday snow to the Midwest. This also delivers some Thursday quick hitting precipitation to the Northeast region. And then on the south side here, we've got the little trough that brings the precipitation late week to parts of the south and the southeast. So we get these two little troughs that kind of sneak through the flow, and then it's a flattening of the flow from the central plains into the northeast that allows temperatures, again, not to drastically warm up, not to shoot anywhere, well above average, but at least get back to where we should be this time of year, slowly climbing out of this Arctic basement. Now we can look at that with the temperature anomaly forecast. Again, watching what we're looking at today with the core of that coldest air sitting over the central U.S. spreading into the east as we head into the day tomorrow, dealing with temperatures 20 to 25 degrees colder than average across the northeast region on Wednesday. Thursday, they lessen some, 5 to 10 degrees cooler than average. By the time we get to Friday, looking at something similar, we do get a little reinforcing shot over the weekend that's going to drop temperatures back into the 20 to 30 degrees colder than average ballpark as we get into Saturday and Sunday. So one more shot of some cooler air late week before the slow warm-up, perhaps early to mid next week. So I've taken you all the way to November 20th before we're getting any hint here of near average temperatures working their way back into the eastern Corn Belt in the northeast region. So the good news is that's where we're headed. We are looking at a slow warm up, excluding that Saturday and Sunday intrusion of some colder air. But I guess the bad news here is it is a slow climb out of the Arctic basement. Taking a look at precipitation then, as this storm system exits the area, again dealing with kind of a mixed bag here. Snow across eastern New York into northern portions of New Hampshire, Vermont, and Maine. A mixed bag there across parts of eastern New York as well through parts of New Hampshire, Vermont, Maine. And then rain falling as you get towards coastal areas. Now this precipitation does make quick work and get out of the northeast region. We'll have to watch the Wednesday and Thursday system then on the backside. So here we are Tuesday evening. Getting into Tuesday night, perhaps dealing with some lake effect snow coming off of the lakes here, but that is it as far as precipitation goes by the time we get to tonight and into tomorrow morning. A quiet day on Wednesday, and then it is Wednesday night into Thursday morning. We see this next system quickly make its way through, again delivering perhaps some very light precipitation to northern areas here of New York, New Hampshire, Vermont, and Maine. Taking a look at total accumulation of snow here through Friday morning, again, primarily looking at some lake effects, snow impacts, and then high elevation areas here as you head northward across New Hampshire, Vermont, and Maine, dealing with perhaps a mix as you head into the transition zone, and then rain as you get toward coastal areas. Taking it out just a little bit further, again showing you the primarily dry pattern. This system exits here by Tuesday night. We watch Wednesday's system come out of the Midwest, bringing some light precipitation to northern portions of the Northeast here, far northern portions of the Northeast, seeing some light snow Thursday into Friday morning. High pressure on the backside, keeping things quiet as we head into the weekend. Looking at total liquid precipitation then, just taking it into the weekend, so looking at the rest of the work week, heaviest off to the north, lightest as you head off to the south. We'll finish then looking at the temperature forecast for the next 5 days. Your high temperatures for the day on Tuesday from the 20s east to the 30s and 40s. Sorry, 20s west, 30s and 40s east. Colder on Wednesday. Here's your Thursday high temperatures. Friday and Saturday, seeing that return of some colder air across the northeast region over the weekend, and then taking a look at low temperatures. Cold tomorrow morning, waking up in the lower teens across the entire region, mid-teens to 20s on Thursday morning, warming up Friday morning, Saturday morning, seeing that intrusion of some colder air as we get into the weekend. As always, Eric Snodgrass will have our long-range U.S.-focused weather analysis on Wednesday morning, and I will be back to talk about the northeast region on Friday. Have a great day.